Sachin, 99 as skipper, it was tough because some horrible umpiring decisions, shoulder LBW and all of that happened. But even then you got 100. Even then you got multiple 50s. And then came Sydney. So if I could take you there, because what stands out for me in that 2003-04 tour, it can happen to anyone. You were in very good sync from India. All of a sudden you got out in Melbourne, you got a couple of, you know, knocks where you did not get runs. And then it all boiled down to the mind and that patience, giving up on ego. And it can happen to Virat, it can happen to Pujara, it can happen to any one of the current team. Can you tell me about Sydney 241? Because for me, that stands out mentally, how you approached that innings.
See, before we went to Australia, I was in a very good nick. We played Australia in India, and also New Zealand was there as a third team. We played a tri-series. I had scored runs. So when I went to Australia, then I was booming with confidence. And I felt this is the tour where I'm going to make a big statement. I had personally, I had done well on 99 tour in the test series, but the team hadn't been able to put up big totals on the board, and you know, it just did not work out. So here I was determined to, you know, we had a good team, we had a good bowling attack, and I thought if we could start on a, you know, big note, then we can push them on back foot. It's a four test series. If you play the first test well, things can change for us. I got a bad decision, as you said earlier, but those are the things which are behind. But that decision affected me. It was a big mistake, I felt. Second test match, again, I went to play a big shot. I got out to Andy Bickle. In the second innings, I had a partnership, important partnership with Rahul Dravid, and we won that test. We go to Melbourne. I was still feeling good about it. But somewhere, you know, that decision had affected me. It had disturbed me mentally. So in Sydney, I scored runs again in the second innings. I scored some 44 something runs, and trying to play a big shot of Brad Williams, I get out, which was discomforting. First innings, I get out to Brett Lee, flick down the leg.
Yeah.
First ball. I mean, I don't know how I nicked that ball. And I could actually see that Gilchrist was waiting for the ball to come. He was standing so far behind. So those kind of things had disturbed me mentally. But, you know, my conversations with my brother would help a lot. And while we were discussing, somewhere deep within, I knew. Because, you know, every time you play a ball, the sound that you hear is all about how confident you are. And the sound wasn't that bad. The sound was okay. So I still felt this is not the end. This is just a bend along the way. That's okay. And after my conversation with my brother, I realized that there was no weakness as such. If at all there was any weakness, then that weakness was about shot selection. So I need discipline to be in the driving seat. And my natural instincts, they have to be sitting in passenger seat. So my discipline, come what may, even if I was batting 70, 120 or 155, I was always going to have discipline as my driver in that innings.
Fantastic.
And the challenge which my brother threw at me pre-test match was try and stay not out. I don't think any bowler can get you out. It is because of your shot selection. And I took up that challenge and I said, okay, I'm not going to get out this test match. And about not playing cover drive, it happened there and then on the field. I had not decided this earlier. So I went there and I suddenly realized that all the bowlers are bowling, you know, in that corridor on the sixth stump, not even fourth stump. So I said, okay, fine. If you're going to keep bowling away from me and frustrate me, I'm going to take on this challenge and I'm going to frustrate you. It's 1 versus 11. Let's see who loses patience first. I'm not going to play a single cover drive. And that's how it happened there and then on the field. It wasn't planned. Wow. It happened there and then on the field.
I didn't know this.
And it is all about, what you are for the team. But it is not always about natural instincts taking over and this is how I play. It's not about you. It's all about what you are for the team. And I, earlier three test matches, when I looked at the scoreboard, I said, this is not what I am. For that, if I have to make changes, my destination is never going to change. But this time, I will have to take a different route to get there. And I will get there eventually, provided I'm flexible in my mental setup. And I did that. It was unbelievable. It was a different kind of innings. I had to do something different.